Welcome to another real-life subnetting example, guys. In this subnetting example, we will focus on a real university topology and we will divide our IP blocks with subnetting and we will assign these IP addresses to different departments of the university. If you are ready to solve this subnetting question, let's go. In this university network, there are 5 different parts. The first part is administration, the second one is classrooms, third one is labs, fourth one is student accommodation, and the last one is staff. In administration, there is only one workgroup and it needs 20 hosts. For classrooms, there are 4 workgroups and each workgroup needs 40 hosts. There are 2 labs, 2 workgroups, and each workgroup needs 25 hosts. In student accommodation parts, there are 2 workgroups also, and each workgroup needs 120 hosts. Lastly, at staff part, there are 4 workgroups, and each workgroup needs 25 hosts. We have 3 IP blocks. So, to divide our IP blocks, firstly, let's check the highest need. Here, student accommodation needs higher hosts. They need 120 hosts per workgroup, and there are 2 workgroups. So totally, they need 240 hosts. There are also some router interfaces, so we will also take into account them. So we need 1 IP block for this student accommodation, because in an IP block, in a class C/24 IP block, we have 256 addresses and 254 available IP addresses. For student accommodation, we need to use 1 IP block. Here, we need to reach 2 to the x is equal to 128. So, here x is 7 and these are the bits of host bits. And the remaining bits are 25 network bits. So we will use /25 for this part. So let's write the IP address 202.2.10.0/25. This is the first block. And after 128 address, we will find the second one. .2.10.128/25. Here, this one will be used by here, and this one will be used by here. This is the subnetting of the first block. So let's check the second one. The second highest need is in classrooms. They need 40 hosts for each workgroup, and there are 4 different workgroups. So to reach this one, we need to find 2 to the x is equal to 64, because when we select 32, we cannot cover these hosts. So to cover these hosts in each workgroup, we need to select 64. So x is here 6. These are host bits. And when we subtract this value from 32, the total bits, from the total bits, we will find 26. These are our cedar value. Here, let's write the IP addresses again. 202.2.11, this is the second part, second block, .0/26. 202.2.11, .64. So we have 64 addresses between these addresses. 202.2.11.128. These are /26. 202.2.11.192/26. There are 4 different subnets and 4 different blocks here, and each block will be used by these blocks. this is for this, this is for this, and this is for this one, and lastly this one will be, this one value will be come here. We have finished also the second block. Now let's use our last block for the remaining parts. So for the remaining parts, administration needs 20 hosts, labs needs 25 hosts for each workgroup, and staff needs 25 hosts for each workgroup. To cover 25 and 20 hosts, we need to find 2 to the x is equal to 32. So here x is 5. 5 host bits. And again, to find the network bits, we'll subtract this value from 32, and this is 27. This is our seed value, and let's write all the IP addresses for this value. 202.2.12, this is the second block, .0/27. 202.2.12.32/27. We are going 32x32 here. 202.2.12.64/27. 202.2.12. Yes. Let's write the remaining here. Here we have 8 different subnets and 8 different IP blocks. So firstly, this block, the first block, will be used by here. This one will be used the first block. And second block and the third block will be used by here and here. And the four staff parts, let's write here this one, this one, this one, and this one will be used by staff. There are four blocks. And here we have one remaining part. This part will be used by point to point links. So we will use these parts here, 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 and here. So let's also divide this block for point-to-point links. As you remember, for point-to-point links, we use /30. So here, let's divide this one again. So here we will use /30. We need 2 to the 2 to 4. So we need to write this one. This is the first part, /30. After 4 IP addresses, we will find the second one. After four IP addresses, we will find the third one. Again, fourth one. And lastly, this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 different blocks, but we need 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks. So we will use this first four parts for this point-to-point links. Here, 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 and here. So let's see the results. Let me clear my screen. Yes, here are, this is the first block, second, third, and fourth, and these are the IP addresses that we have find before. These are the first block. We have divided it into two. These are the second block. We have divided it into four. And these are the third block. We have divided it eight. And we have used 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 subnets here. And the last subnet was used in these point-to-point connections. Yes, guys, we have finished our real-life subnetting problem. We have divided our three IP blocks into different subnets, and we have used our IP blocks very efficiently. And if you understood this lesson correctly, I think you will be ready to solve real-life subnetting problems. Good luck!